Testosterone isn't just about muscle mass or libido. It plays a role in bone density, energy, mood, and overall well-being. If your levels are low, the underlying causes may surprise you. I'm going to go over the five unexpected reasons, so let's get started. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below, and if you enjoyed the content, turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Now, it's natural for your testosterone levels to dip as you age, and this chart here does a good job in explaining that. Your 30s are when your T levels tend to start dropping naturally, but some even have lower than normal T levels in their 20s to 40s. And what is that number, you might ask? Here is a chart that looks at typical ranges for each age group. And according to the American Urology Association, for adults, low testosterone is considered to be less than 300 nanograms per deciliter. So keep that in mind. And as for conditions that lower T levels, there is, of course, primary hypogonadism, for example, and Klinefelter syndrome, which at birth can cause two or more X chromosomes to be present in addition to one Y chromosome, or secondary hypogonadism, for example, if you have a pituitary disorder. Keep in mind, these are just two examples, but as far as the first reason why your T levels may have dropped is because of an increase in visceral fat. Visceral fat is the fat stored deep inside your belly, surrounding vital organs like the liver, pancreas, and intestines. And unlike the fat under your skin, which you could pinch, visceral fat hides inside your body and plays a bigger role in health problems. When you eat more calories than your body needs, especially from sugary or fatty foods, and don't burn them off through activity, your body stores the extra energy as fat, and sometimes it gets tucked away around your organs where it's called visceral fat. The problem with that is that it lowers testosterone by converting it into estrogen via the enzyme aromatase found in these fat cells. The other thing to keep in mind is that an excess in adipose tissue also leads to chronic inflammation, raising cytokines, the two being interleukin-6, aka IL-6, and tumor necrosis factor alpha, aka TNF-alpha. These will go on and impair the HPG axis and reduce testosterone synthesis. I have a video that looks at lowering visceral fat with over 500,000 views, should you wish to learn more about ways to lower it. Highly recommend you watching that one next. Further than this, visceral fat may lead to insulin resistance, which will further reduce testosterone as it can increase oxidative stress in your Leydig cells, disrupting the ability to produce testosterone. So yeah, visceral fat accumulation is no good. The second reason is chronic stress. Stress elevates cortisol levels, which has a direct inhibitory effect on your testosterone production. The reason for that is because cortisol suppresses the HPG axis by reducing GnRH secretion from the hypothalamus. It also competes with your testosterone precursors like pregnenolone, which diverts resources toward cortisol production instead of testosterone. Because you have to remember, cortisol and testosterone share some of the same resources in your body. So when cortisol is high, testosterone production takes a back seat. If you look up this article from the American Psychological Association, go to the section on personal life stresses for Gen Z versus adults overall, you can see clearly that they are more stressed about work, more stressed about money, more stressed about health-related concerns, but interestingly less stressed about the economy. Comment down below what your thoughts are on this. Does the younger generation have more stress than, let's say, the millennials did? But moreover, the conversation gets more interesting when you take a look at how these stressors impact nitric oxide production, reducing blood flow to the testes. That's why I made these two videos here on L-arginine and one on L-citrulline that looks at how to boost nitric oxide. The third reason is because of the exposure to endocrine disruptors. And there are many around us today. BPA, for example, phthalates and pesticides can mimic estrogen or interfere with androgen receptor signaling. Specifically BPA, as it's believed to reduce testosterone production by inhibiting the activosteroidogenic enzymes, a big one being CYP11A1, which converts cholesterol into pregnenolone, which is the first step in testosterone synthesis. And guys, I'm still planning on making a part two of my hormone disruptors video, which a lot of you guys have been saying you want a part two for it. If you haven't watched the first one, I highly recommend you doing so. The fourth reason is because of sleep deprivation and lack of sleep quality. Interestingly, there was an article that I found to be quite alarming. Falling asleep is harder for Gen Z than it was for millennials, but staying asleep is hard for both of them. Chronic sleep deprivation increases cortisol and reduces growth hormone, both of which impact the HPG axis in a negative way. This is especially true if you have obstructive sleep apnea. Here we find several studies to have confirmed a strong relationship between obstructive sleep apnea and low testosterone. Testosterone is associated with pituitary gonadal function, and obstructive sleep apnea is a direct cause of decreased pituitary gonadal function. So if you want to gasp for air during sleep, your breathing pauses, or you snore very loudly, or let's say you wake up with a headache or dry mouth, it may be best to check to see if you have sleep apnea, because correcting it can help restore your testosterone levels. And lastly, there are some treatments that lower testosterone levels that you should know of: ketoconazole, spironolactone, your statin medications, and cimetidine, to name a few. If you suspect that your medications could be the reason for a drop in your T levels, talk to your doctor to see if the benefits outweigh the risks, or if you could switch to an alternative that won't hamper with your T levels.